that this is all. Normally you would look at TNC and say to yourselves, okay, maybe they're grouped up too much, they're not getting enough out of the map. But the fact of the matter is, with a Terrorblade at 23 minutes and the item progression that he has, you can just go kill the base. You don't have to wait. There's not many times in Dota, I think, nowadays where you see a lineup that's actually so inept at defending high ground. But Fnatic's team is not really the greatest high ground defense. It's only Lasso.
I mean, this is honestly a great story for TNC, you know, failing in the first qualifier for Southeast Asia against RRQ from Indonesia. Second qualifier, they do get themselves through, the open qualifier that is, but then Batrider is ripped apart, the Terrorblade, few hits in there, the single death, the Juggernaut drop finally, and the EMP is good, but it's still the Terrorblade up on the front line, the Samage holds the line, Chrono still available in mid one, held inside it as well. Is the relocate saved? There's a heal through, but it's not enough, he's actually Chronoed and didn't get the relocate out. This is TNC actually looking to take down Fnatic in this first best of one. Mushi, you can't run, you can't hide. The Terrorblade is taking down the planet. Lasso comes through pure fight. Glimpse at the Fortune Zen. Keep the TP alive as he swaps the elf back onto mid one. And DJ's wish not long for this world. They're just chasing them into tier 4s, chasing them into base because Fnatic, they don't really have anything left. Without the Batriders jumping at Lasso's sword back, he tries as hard as they'll get the AU. Oracle down at last. The demon will get shoved back to his grave as well. But they've lost so much structurally here in their base that Fnatic, this is all really consolatory for them. Raven finally dies, but it is the Aegis the Immortal. Is he going to die a second time, though?
Yeah, he'll definitely die again. He doesn't have BKB.
Yeah, no BKB and no Sunder.